This is functional code in a programming language I made called Bossing. But why? Well, all programming languages nowadays feel boring. It's all just const, let, print, the same keywords over and over again. And I have an idea. We all know TypeScript is the best language ever made for real no cap. So what if we use it to create a programming language with a syntax inspired from Gen Z slang? Well, you end up with Bossing. Lit num be no cap right now. But hold up, what is a programming language? Well, a programming language allows you to write code in a way that can be translated into instructions your computer CPU can execute. There are two main types of programming languages, compiled and interpreted. Compiled programming languages are those that are compiled to binary, such as Rust, C++, and C. Interpreted programming languages are those that have their code read line by the interpreter, such as Python, JavaScript, and Ruby. Bossing, the programming language, has two parts, the frontend and the runtime. The frontend has the lexer, parser, and the AST. The frontend's main responsibility is to process the source code and transform it into a format that the interpreter can work with. The runtime's responsibility, however, is to run the processed code the frontend provided. Now, you might wanna know, why am I doing this, right? Why am I making a programming language? Well, there's really no reason. I want to code in an isolang, but I'm too lazy to learn one, so... And I also wanna see how fucked up it would be to write it in JavaScript.
Just don't write your compiler in JavaScript, please, for the love of all things good and great and holy. Stop writing tools in JavaScript.
Well, TypeScript, but you get it. I'm following a tutorial, by the way, more about that at the end. Alright, so now that we know what a programming language is and how it operates, let's say this is our script, 10 plus 5. The lexer would format it like this, each valid character being represented with a type. Then the parser will actually parse it so the interpreter would know what to do. As you can see, there's a body, which is the source code, with a binary expression. This is the AST, by the way. I know this starts to get kinda complicated, but bear with me. So now our code, 10 plus 5, passes the frontend and is now at the backend. The interpreter for now has two values, null and number. We'll support more the more we advance. Each type has its own interface. For example, a number in the interpreter would look something like this. Now back to the interpreter, we pass the AST and the interpreter evaluates it, returning the value. In our case, it iterates over the body, finds the binary expression, and evaluates the left-hand side of the operation with the right-hand side, following the operator. And finally, we get binary expressions. But we don't support variables yet, so let's do that. A variable has an identifier, which is the name, a value, and a boolean that represents whether the variable is constant or not. The tricky part is the parser. The function that handles it will receive the following statement. It will create a variable storing whether the first keyword is let or const, and expect the variable name. After that, we check if there is a semicolon, which means that the variable was made but it was not set, and if it is, we set the value to null. But if the variable declaration continues, we expect an equal sign and parse the expression that comes after it. Now that we have the frontend done for the variable, we have to introduce a new part of the runtime, the scope. The scope will act as a class with a variable set as a map, which will hold our variables, and some helper functions like declare variable and assign variable. And just like that, we have variables. We can also set them to new values. But we forgot about data types for a second. Currently we only have null and number, so let's add objects too. They were a little messy, so... Let's speedrun through them. If the current token is an open brace, we enter parse object expression mode. With the open brace, create an array of properties, loop through the rest until we find the closed brace, expect an identifier, which is the key. We allow shorthand syntax by assuming the key is a variable. We'll expect a colon, parse the value, push it, and expect a closing brace. After that, we basically create a map in the interpreter which would hold the object entries, and objects are there. We won't support arrays for now, not that I can't do it, I'm just lazy. I also implemented functions which have a name and a body of statements. We basically do what we did before, parsing the arguments provided, and importantly, in the interpreter, we create a new scope inside the function so things like variable overlapping won't happen. Since functions were done, I also added native functions such as println. But by this point you're probably wondering, where is the funny Gen Z syntax? Well, let me elaborate. Natively supporting the Gen Z syntax... Why am I even referring to it like that? You know what, I'll keep on doing that. To natively support the Gen Z syntax, we would have to heavily modify the lexer and the parser, like, really, to the point where this would turn into a classic face certified code. So instead of that, we'll have support for both normal and Gen Z syntaxes. How, you may ask? Well, it's as simple as separating both by file extensions. Normal having the .bs extension, and the Gen Z having the .bsx extension. So back to the coding part, we need more data types. Objects, null, and numbers are not enough. Considering we can make constant variables, we can create a variable called true, which will have its value to true, and same for false. But you may also notice that I didn't mention strings, and don't worry, I did implement those. We can also utilize native functions to create the println command, then some code to get rid of the JavaScript fingerprint on the console.long function. So, in my opinion at least, it's not a programming language if it doesn't have if statements and loops, so let's implement them. If statements were quite a pain to deal with since we had to also implement comparisons, which are a part of binary expression, which messed up everything. I don't care what you think. It works, do not touch it. Nah, just kidding, I rewrote that when implementing not equal. With comparisons working, if statements were just some parser fun for a few minutes. I also added the else statements and did not forget to make them have their own scope. Now loops are left, which basically consist of a variable declaration, expression, and assignment expression. Then of course we have the body. Also, I haven't implemented continue or break. If you have the expression, deal with it. I also added the and or operator, and you cannot chain them. Not because I don't know how to fix it, it's because it's bad practice in bossing. Now I want to implement more functions. strcon will merge the values provided into a string. Format will replace the $ open brace, close brace in the first parameter with the following parameters following it. And other math functions such as math.random, math.round, math.abs. I also implemented syntax highlighting. Do not ask me how. I gave myself about 2 hours yesterday night to finish it and somehow I wrote this. Not really functional, but who needs those colored words anyway? Am I right or am I right? I could have made it better only if there was an actual tutorial online. Microsoft and proprietary software. Anyway, that was a lot of talking. Let's get to the real part. Bossing X. We create a file with the bossing X expression, and we can run our BS code just fine, but we can also write it with the intended bossing X syntax, which is lit xp no cap right now. We can run this code just fine, so let's start waffling the output. Loops are an essential part of programming languages, therefore bossing X handles them gently. To create a loop, you can use the following code. Yaml lit ib0 right now, ismol 10 right now, ibi plus 1. Waffle strcon currently at i. It's very simple. You lit an I to be 0 right now, then check if I is smaller than 10 right now, then I to be I plus 1. We'll yell through the loop and waffle the I. As you may know, most languages represent the NOT operator with the exclamation mark. Bossing X takes a superior approach, representing the NOT operator with the semicolon. Do not worry though. If you don't wish to use semicolon B to do not equal, you can use NOT. To access math functions, you can use, for example, NERD.random. As you may also know, in JavaScript you can use $ open brace close brace to format a value into a string. Bossing X takes a superior approach by allowing you to use your local currency symbol. As you may additionally know, some languages support types. Bossing X takes a superior approach by allowing you to insert types to anything. A function, a variable, binary expression, everything. The following script is valid. You can also type a type. Types don't do anything. In fact, they're removed before the lexer kicks in. We at Bossing X believe comments are redundant and bad practice, therefore they are not supported. As you may also know, you can safely execute your code by using a try-catch in some programming languages. In Bossing X, you can make a try-catch by using fuck around and find out. Also, the error isn't passed via the find out keyword, it's just a global mutable variable. You can also utilize our blazingly fast command line function by using the clapback function. So now you may be wondering, what's the black magic powering Bossing X? Well, it's just a simple replace function. Your Bossing X code gets rewritten in Bossing automatically. Bossing X was ironic if you couldn't tell. The project will be in description. Also, if you make some crazy stuff with Bossing X, I might add your script in the GitHub repo. A huge thanks to Tyler for creating the Guide to Interpreter series on YouTube. If you want to create your own programming language or understand how interpreters work, you can follow his tutorials. Thanks for watching, and as always, see you in the next one. Yaml lit ib0 right now, ismol 10 right now, ibi